我们不知道这根刺是什么，可能是他身体的疼痛，还是说是某一个其他的一个什么东西，我们不知道。
We don't know what this thorn is. Maybe it's some kind of physical ailment.
但是神没有应允他的祷告，但神给了他一句话。
But God has not answered his prayer, but God gave him a word.
大家知道这句话是什么？
Do you know what word that God has given to him?
我的恩典是够你用的。
My grace is sufficient for you.
所以这次我看到我们的扩张的筹款，我有三个方面的感想。
And this time that I see the pledge that we have for our expansion ministry, I have three reflections.
所以最大的一句话就是神给保罗这句话，说我的恩典够你用的。
And the greatest reflection is this word that God has given to Paul, that my grace is sufficient for you.
首先第一点，我在这里就是看到神的信实和神的恩典。
Here I see God's faithfulness and his grace.
神在圣经上应允我们说我的恩典够你用的。
And in the Bible, the God promises us that His grace is sufficient for us.
我们知道我们扩堂的，我们是设定目标，我们总共的是要资金是65万左右。
We know that our entire cost for expansion is about 650,000.
那昨天在执事会里面，我们就发现，我们加上我们现在的 saving， 加上弟兄姐妹的贷款，然后再加弟兄姐妹的奉献，我们一共是68万。
And now, according to with the loan and with the pledge and everything that we have in the bank, we have about 680,000.
所以你会看到这个数字，你会看到神的奇妙的带领，65万，但神给了68万。
And you see this number that we needed 650,000, but God has given 680.
神没有给我们80万。
God didn't give us 800,000.
神就给我们68万。
And God gave us 680,000.
恩典是够你用的。
This His grace is sufficient for us.
我们看到神的信实，看到神的 faithfulness.
We see God's faithfulness.
那另外一点，从这点的话，我们也看到，我有一点我是觉得是很欣慰的。当我看到这个数字，我其实心里面有点放下来。
And there's another point that I reflect when I look at the numbers.
因为我一直在担心我们是不是能够筹到这个足够的资金。
Because I'm very worried whether we can get enough funds for this expansion.
但是看到这个数字以后，我有一个另一个方面一个感恩的事情，就是说，我们这个意向也通过这次的事情也得到一个印证。
And the other reflection is that through these numbers that we have, our vision is confirmed.
我们知道我们的意向是我们这个地方要从一个200到300人的教会。
And we know that our vision is to increase this area to about 200 and 300 congregations.
这200到300个人的教会是包括小孩子和幼子的。
And this includes the youth and the children.
但是所以这个意向有这样的意向，我们第一步就是要扩。扩我们的教室，然后和厕所。
So with such a vision, the first step is to have more classrooms and bathrooms.
所以我们扩堂的这个 project 就是在这个意向的下面前，我们走出的第一步。
So this is the first step that we've taken under this vision, the first step in this project.
但是我们在这当中，我们看到神的印证。
But in this
数字，我们看到神的印证。
And through this number, we have seen that God has given us a confirmation and a sign.
所以在这里面。真的是向神献上感恩和赞美。
And in this, I give thanks and praise to God.
第三点
，the third reflection，
可能弟兄姐妹就不喜欢听了。
And maybe you don't want to hear it anymore.
我在这里看到我们的亏欠。
And we see here our lack.
神是信实的。
God is faithful.
神信实的供应我们。
And God has faithfully provided for us.
但是在这当中，我们看到我们真的是很亏欠。
But in the midst, we see our lack tremendously.
我们如果你看这些扩堂的奉献的话，你看有那个奉献基本上集中在一个少数的人的少数那几个人当中。
And if you look at the offering, it's concentrated on a particular individual, just a few of them.
有关于奉献，我在这里不能提名字，但我知道有一位姐妹奉献了11万左右。
And I cannot give some names, but I know there's a sister who has given about
还有另外一老姐妹一奉献就是1万2万。
And some other older, elderly sister has given 10,000 to 20,000.
那我们这个所有的资金当中，我们有弟兄姐妹无息的带给我们，是一共加起来是27万。
And so together with all the interest and everything with the loan is about 270,000.
我们亏欠的在哪里？
But where is our lack?
我们除了这几位弟兄姐妹，我们其他20几个家庭，总共的奉献在3万多。
But other than these few individuals, all 23 families of our church, we only come up to about 35,000.
看到我们的亏欠没有
？You see where our lack is.
但是感谢主，主是信实的。虽然我们这不配的人这么 软弱的人，但是主仍然信实地供应我们。
We give thanks to God that even though we are so weak, but God has provided for us.
所以我们现在的总共大概是有27万的贷款，我们要在10年之内还清，基本上每个月的还款是2200。
And so now we have about 270,000 worth of loan that we need to pay in 10 years every month.
盼望弟兄姐妹能够看到神的我们神的信实、神的带领。盼望弟兄姐妹在这个，在这个每个月的还款上面，我们能够在这个上面能够奉献，能够 cover 这样的一个还款。
And we hope that brothers and sisters will be moved by the Lord that we may cover this loan that we have.
2200，其实我们有100多人，其实每个人一个月只要多奉献20块钱就可以了。
And about 2,200, we have about 100 over in our congregation. If everybody gives $20 more, we can cover it for the loan.
可能你少去几次麦当劳，或者是少去一次的饭店就够了。
Perhaps you just go one last time to the restaurant or to McDonald's, and it will be enough.
大家有没有这样的信心来 cover 这两千二？
Do you have this?
每个月的两千二。
Do you have this faith to cover this 2,200 every month?
感谢主。
And we give thanks to God.
Amen.
Amen.
好，我们言归正传，我们回到我们加拉太书的3:1-14。
And so let's return back to chapter 3 of Galatians.
那么它的这个标题是信心还是行为
？And the topic is by faith or by works.
所以我们来，如果你有圣经，请翻到加拉太书的3:1-14。
If you have your Bible, I invite you to turn to Galatians chapter 3 verses 1-14.
所以翻到以后，我邀请众弟兄姐妹起立，我们用起音的方式一起来读啊。
And when you're there, I invite you to stand as we read God's word.
我来读一节，请弟兄姐妹来读一节。
Now we will read responsively.
3:1，无知的加拉太人呐、啊，耶稣基督钉十字架，已经活化在你们眼前，谁又迷惑了你们呢？
Let me ask you only this. Did you receive the Spirit by works of the law or by hearing with faith?
你们既靠圣灵入门，如今还靠肉身成全吗？你们是这样的无知吗？
Did you suffer so many things in vain, if indeed it was in vain?
那赐给你们的圣灵，又在你们中间行异能的，是因你们行律法呢？是因你们听信福音呢？
And it was counted to him as righteousness.
所以你们要知道，那以信为本的人就是亚伯拉罕的子孙。
And the scripture, foreseeing that God would justify the Gentiles by faith, preached the gospel beforehand to Abraham, saying, "In you shall all the nations be blessed."
可见那以信为本的人和有信心的亚伯拉罕一同得福。
For all who rely on works of the law are under a curse, for it is written, Cursed be everyone who does not abide by all things written in the book of the law and do them.
没有一个人靠着律法在神面前称义，这是明显的，因为经上说，义人必因信得生。
But the law is not of faith, rather, the one who does them shall live by them.
基督既为我们受了咒诅，就赎出我们脱离律法的咒诅，以为经上记着，凡挂在木头上都是被咒诅的。
So that in Christ Jesus the blessing of Abraham might come to the Gentiles, so that we might receive the promised Spirit through faith.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
天父，亲爱的主，我们感谢赞美你。
O Lord, Heavenly Father, we give thanks and praise to you.
我们感谢你在基督里面释放我们，感谢你在基督里面让我们能够得以自由。
We thank you that you have released us from bondage in Christ that we may have freedom.
主啊，我们求你今天就在我们的当中居首位掌王权，你的圣灵充满这里。
And we pray that this very day you be exalted and be lifted up high and the Spirit fill this place.
主啊，让我们在这里能够看到你的荣耀，让我们在这里能够敬拜来赞美你。
O Lord, that we may see your glory at this very place and to praise you and worship you.
我们这样的祷告，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名。
We pray this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. 大家请坐。
Please be seated.
好，加拉太书的一个主题就是因信称义。
Now one of the theme of Galatians is the justification by faith.
我们知道这 这本书对马丁路德的影响是非常大的。
We know that this book has a tremendous influence on Martin Luther.
我们也上次讲过，当马丁路德他在那个律法当中挣扎的时候，当他靠着肉体、靠着行为当中挣扎的时候，当他看到这卷书的时候，他就得以释放。
And we've mentioned that when he was struggling with his flesh and about fulfilling the law, when he read this book, he was released and freed.
所以加拉太书的一个最重要的主题就是因信称义。
So one of the greatest theme of Galatians is justification by faith.
所以如果你要知道福音在讲什么，因信称义在讲什么，那你就回到加拉太书。
Now if you want to know what the gospel is and what is justification by faith, you have to come back to Galatians.
那同样你会在加拉太书当中，你会发现保罗后来在写罗马书的时候，他有很多的东西是与加拉太书类似的，他是发展了他在加拉太书当中所写的东西。
And you realize that later on when Paul write the book of Romans, he has extended some of his arguments in Galatians.
那我们这段经文保罗就在讲，我们是靠是因信称义呢，我们是靠 faith 呢，还是靠我们的行为？
And here Paul is asking us, is it by faith that we're justified or is it by works?
在三章一节，保罗在这里说：“无知的加拉太人呐、啊，耶稣基督钉十字架已经活化在你们的眼前。”
In verse 1, Paul says, "O foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? It was before your eyes that Jesus Christ was portrayed."
我觉得中文这个翻译很好，他说已经活化在你们眼前。
And it says here is portrayed as crucified before your eyes.
那英文是 portrayed 在你们的眼前。
It's portrayed before you.
所以什么叫活化呢？
What does it mean to be portrayed?
就是活生生的，好像一个 picture 一样，画在你们的眼前。
It's like a picture that's been portrayed before you.
保罗说，耶稣基督钉十字架，耶稣基督为我们所做的一切已经活化在你们眼前，你们还要受谁的迷惑呢？
And Paul says Jesus Christ was already publicly portrayed as crucified before you. Who are you? Who has bewitched you?
在接下来的四节当中，三节当中，二到。四节当中，二到五节当中，保罗就在这里讲，就是说，保罗在这里就提供了三个三点的论证。
And then in verses 2-5, Paul gives 3 points to support his argument.
那么第一点就是保罗在这里说，你们受了圣灵是因你们行律法呢，还是因为你们听福音呢？
And so the first point is this: Did you receive the Spirit by works or by the law or by hearing with faith?
所以保罗在第一点讲到圣灵，对不对？
And so the first point Paul talks about Holy Spirit.
在第三节说你们是靠圣灵入门的，对不对？
He says that in verse 3 that you have entered through the Spirit.
你们既然靠圣灵入了门，那么现在还要靠律法来成全吗？
And now you have begun by the Spirit. Are you now being perfected by the law?
还要靠肉身来成全吗？
Are you being perfected by the flesh.
所以保罗第一点讲到圣灵。
So the first point Paul talks about the Holy Spirit.
保罗就在这里为加拉太人，你们当初领受圣灵是因为你们靠着你们的肉体，靠着你们的行为，靠着你们遵守律法领受圣灵呢，还是说因为福音的缘故你们才领受圣灵？
And Paul asked them, when you receive the gospel, is it because of your works or is it by the works of the Spirit through the gospel?
所以当我们知道在当圣灵降临的时候，五旬节圣灵降临的时候，彼得起来讲道，然后有很多人信主，三千人信主，彼得就说了一句话，然后说这是应许是给你们和你们的后裔的。
And so in Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit comes upon the congregation, and Peter said that this promise is for you and to your children.
那这应许什么？就是要圣灵要充满你们。
And what is this promise? This is the promise of the Spirit pouring out.
圣灵要降临，要充满你们。
This Spirit is to come and to be poured out upon you.
所以这圣灵是在应许当中的，这圣灵不是说靠着我们的行为，靠着我们来遵守律法来赢得的。
So this Spirit comes through promise, it's not through the works that we're doing.
所以保罗在这里说，你们领受圣灵是因为福音呢，还是因为你们的行为呢？
And so Paul asked them, do you receive the Spirit by your works or is it by the gospel?
那对加拉太省的这些基督徒来说，他们很明白。但是所以保罗在这里呼召他们来回想他们当初信主的那个时候是因为什么信主的。
So Paul asked them to recall at the moment when they believed, why did they believe in Christ?
所以在他们领受圣灵是因为福音的缘故。
And they receive the Spirit on account of the gospel.
所以他们让他们来回想圣灵在他们当中的工作。
And they are to recall the work of the Spirit among them.
你们靠圣灵来入门。
And that you have begun by the Spirit.
那圣灵在他们当中做了什么样的工作呢？
And what works did the Spirit do among them?
对我们所有的基督徒来说，我们相信，如果你真正重生的基督徒，我相信你有这样的经历。
Now to all of us who are real believers, I believe you have this experience.
圣灵首先重生了我们。
And first of all, the Holy Spirit regenerated us.
但每个人重生的经历可能不一样。
Now, of course, everyone have different experience of regeneration.
那有些人可能就是说出生在基督教的家庭里面，然后长在这个环境里面，在不知不觉当中就重生了。
And some may have grown up in a Christian family and unknowingly they have been regenerated.
那我没有这样的经历，但我的经历是有一点那个特别，有一点奇怪的那个感动了。就我相信每个。对我们这些半路出家的基督徒来说，可能都会有这样的经历。
But,
大多数有这样的经历。
For the first generation Christians, I believe that most of us will have some kind of experience when we were regenerated.
所以当我在那个时候，当他们在学员团契的，他们向我传福音的时候，大概就是那二十分钟的时间，我心里面就有一种怪怪的、说不出来的那样的感动。
And in the days of crew when they were preaching the gospel to me, and in that 20 minutes, I feel this weird sensation about in my heart.
所以当他们后来问我的时候，你要不要信？我也不知道为什么，就说我愿意信。
And at the point when they asked me, "Do you want to believe in this?" I just said yes.
我也不知道为什么在二十分钟的时间我能够掉下眼泪。
And I don't know that why in 20 minutes I shed my tear.
所以你说这个靠这两个人，他能够在二十分钟的时间让我掉下眼泪来，我想不可能的事情。
I think it's quite impossible if you get two persons to talk to me in 20 minutes for me to shed my tear.
是重生的工作。
And that is the work of the regeneration of the spirit.
所以后来当我们去传福音的时候，我们也看到这样的工作在别人的身上。
And so when we go and preach the gospel, we see this work upon others as well.
我记得我们在当时在一个校园里面传福音，我们就抓到一个男生，然后向他传福音。大概就在那几十分钟之后，然后他就我们看到他。站起来，我们看到他眼泪就已经在眼眶里面。当他站起来走的时候，我们看他走的样子都有点怪怪的那个样子。
And so we caught of a guy in the college and we preached the gospel to him. And after we finished and we saw him with tears in his eyes and he just walked away after that.
这种怪怪的是好的怪怪的。
And this is the good kind of weirdness.
因为圣灵在他的心里面工作。
Because the Spirit is working in his heart.
所以这是重生的工作。
And this is the work of regeneration.
所以你们，我们想起我们重生的时候经历，那有没有圣灵的工作
？And so when we think of our regeneration, is there the work of the Spirit?
那圣灵不但有重生的工作，圣灵在我们重生的过程当中也会来感动我们，也会来带领我们。
And the Spirit not just only have the works of regeneration, but in our life, it continues to lead and guide us in sanctification.
所以有很多的弟兄姐妹，我们一起聊天的时候，有很多弟兄姐妹或者是一些不信的朋友，他问我，就你有没有听过上帝对你说话
？And so many brothers and sisters perhaps has asked me during our casual talk, "Have you heard God speaking audibly to you?"
哦，很难回答。
It's hard for me to answer.
所以我就说，你要首先定义什么叫说话。
Now you have to first define what does it mean by God speaking to you.
那如果你要上帝向我说话，就像摩西现在对我说话一样，那我说那是没有。
Now if you define speaking to you as being speaking audibly like me talking to him, then no.
但是上帝确实向我说话。
But God has truly spoken to me.
确实通过圣灵来向我们说话。
And he has spoken to me through the Holy Spirit.
所以有很多的事情在没有发生之前，我基本上心里面就有这感动，就已经知道了。
And so many things before they happen, there's this moving in my heart that I basically kind of know what's going to happen.
那所以上帝没有。这样直接的对我说，但是上帝通过圣灵就在我心里面感动我。
God has not spoken to me audibly, but he has spoken to me indirectly through the Spirit.
有很多这样的事情。
And there are many, many such situations.
就比方说上次那个师母回国的时候，他这个申请签证的时候。
So for example, the time when my wife went back to China and the reapplication of her visa.
所以到后来，在我祷告当中的时候，那这圣灵就已经对我说是 OK， 没事了。
So eventually, at the later part of my prayer, the Spirit has comforted me and said that it's okay, it'll be okay.
所以我的人生经历当中有很多次这样的经历。
And in my experiences, there's many such situations.
我记得在2014年我来这里实习的时候
，I remember in 2014 when I come here for an internship.
暑假在这里实习有两个月的时间。
And I spent 2 months here in the summer.
所以当那次实习之后，当我还在这个实习过程当中，当时我就已经就是圣灵已经给我说，就说你会留在这里。
And during the internship, I have this moving in my heart that I will probably stay here at this place.
这真是很多时候是很奇妙的事情。
And there are many such situations.
所以后来回去的时候，我就没有再继续去申请 PhD 的，再继续再申请 PhD。
So after that, when I returned, I stopped reapplying for a PhD program.
我相信我们的很多弟兄姐妹，我们的心，我们的生命当中，你都有这样的经历，都有这样的圣灵的感动和引领。
I believe that many brothers and sisters, you have such experience of God guiding and leading you.
所以保罗在这里就为加拉太省的基督徒说，你们当中有这么多圣灵的经历，你们有这么多圣灵给你们的感动和引领，你们现在为什么要回头呢？
And Paul asked the Galatians, no, you have so much work of the Spirit among you that he is guiding and leading you. Why are you returning back?
圣灵当初来到你们中间，在你们中间工作，是因为你们的行为，还是因为你们听了福音呢？
And the Holy Spirit has come upon you and work in you. Is it because of your works, or is it because that you have heard the gospel?
所以保罗说，你们既然靠圣灵入门，是圣灵带着你们进来的，你们为什么现在要靠肉体呢？
And Paul says, since you have having begun by the Spirit, why are you now being perfected by the flesh?
这是保罗讲的第一点。那第二点就是保罗在第四节讲的，你们受苦如此之多，难道都是白受的吗？
And then Paul moves on to the second point. He says, do you suffer so many things in vain?
难道都是突然的吗？
Is it really in vain?
如果你们为主的缘故，为义的缘故，受了如此多的逼迫，受了如此多的苦，但是你们现在还不能够得救，还要去遵守律法，还要去行割礼，还要去遵守那个食物上的法律，那么你们的受苦是白受的吗？
Now, if you have been persecuted for the sake of your faith, do you still have to go back and keep all these laws? Isn't it in vain that you have been suffering?
我们不是说不要遵守律法，而是说不是遵守律法来得救。
We're not saying that you don't keep the law, but we're not keeping the law in order to be saved.
但如果你们回头的话，你们受的这些苦都是白受了。
Now, if you return back, then all the sufferings that you have were in vain.
这是第二点。第三点，保罗讲到圣灵在你们当中行了那么多的神迹奇事，对不对？行了那么多的异能，这都是你们亲眼看到的。那你们现在为什么要怀疑呢？
And the third point, Paul says that he supplies you with all the works and miracles. You have seen it, you have heard it. Now, why do you doubt?
所以这段经文也给我们今天看到，就是我们基督徒，我们今天会问一个问题：我们怎样才有得救的确据呢？我们怎么样才确信我得救呢？
And so this scripture also says to us, how can we have our assurance of salvation?
这段经文也给我们在某种程度上也回答了这个问题。
And in a certain aspect, it also answered our question through the scripture.
你有没有那圣灵重生的经历？你有没有圣灵带领的经历？你有没有在圣灵当中呢，结出那个圣灵的果子来？
Do you have this? Do you experience this guiding and leading by the Holy Spirit? Do you bear the fruit of the Spirit?
你有没有这种经历，为义受逼迫，为耶稣的名受逼迫的这样的经历？
Do you have the experience of being persecuted by the sake of the righteousness of God?
从这些都当中，你就知道你是得救的。
And through all this, you know that you are a believer.
然后保罗紧接着在下面谈到亚伯拉罕的例子。
And then Paul goes on to talk about the example of Abraham.
保罗为什么要谈到亚伯拉罕呢？
Why does Paul talk about Abraham then?
我知道亚伯拉罕是谁。
Who is Abraham?
信心之父，有人说亚伯拉罕是信心之父，但亚伯拉罕在以色列人当中的位置是什么？
And what is the position of Abraham in the heart of the Israelites?
亚伯拉罕是他们的祖先，对不对？
Abraham is their ancestor.
在以色列人的心目当中，亚伯拉罕是一个很重要的人。
In the heart of the Israelites, Abraham is very, very important.
可以说是他们的源头。
He is their ancestor, their first Jew.
那么，而且在圣经，在创世纪里面，神与亚伯拉罕立约，神说万国要因你的后裔来得福。
And in Genesis, God promised Abraham that the nations shall be blessed through you.
而且赐下割礼作为立约的这个记号。
And he's given him the sign of circumcision as the promise.
所以保罗在这里再回到亚伯拉罕。
So Paul here returns back to Abraham.
保罗在这个第六节说，亚伯拉罕信神，这就算为他的义。
And here he says, Abraham believed God, and it was counted to him as righteousness.
什么叫算为他的义？
What does it mean to be counted as his righteousness?
他是为什么算他为义呢？
Why is he counted as righteous?
什么叫算为他的义？
What is counted to him as righteousness?
啊？啊？不是。OK, 还没有。OK。就不是真正是他的，对吗？算他为义，对不对
？That is, it is not his own righteousness, but it's counted to him.
那最近我们家买了个象棋，所以我经常就和我 女儿和还有太太下象棋。
And so we bought a chess set recently in our house, and we've been playing chess.
我们下象棋有一个默认的规则，就是说他们可以回棋，我不能回棋。
There is a unknown principle is that they can retract the steps, but I can't.
所以每次当我就是说有很多次我的车被他们无意间吃掉的时候，我说我要回棋。
So many times when one of my pawn was taken, I said I want to retract my steps.
因为那个车实在是太重要了，对吗？如果少一个车的话，你基本上就是，你这棋就完蛋了，对吧
？So this very important pawn. If you lose it, then you most probably lose.
所以我要回棋。
So I want to retract my steps.
那我太太和女儿说不能回棋。
And my wife and daughter
你不能回棋
no, you can't retract your steps.
那最后就输了。
And then I lost.
最后输了，我就说算你赢吧。
And I count as your victory.
所以这就叫算。
This is called counting.
对，所以神说亚伯拉罕信神，因为他的信 faith， 所以神就算他为义。
And so when Abraham believed God because of his faith, believing God counts him as righteous.
那其实这段经文在保罗在罗马书的第四章有发展。
And this scripture actually Paul extends it a little bit more in Romans 4.
保罗在罗马书的第四章的时候就解释什么叫算。
And in Romans 4, Paul explains what is this counting.
保罗首先举了个例子，叫做工的得工价的例子。
And Paul at first gives an example of those who work deserve their wages.
所以一个人如果他工作了，他做工了，他得到这个工价，那是他应该得的，那不应该是算他的，对吧
？And so if a person worked, then he deserves the wages. It's not counted to him. He deserves it.
但只有那些不做工的，而且得到这个工价了，得到这个恩典了，这才叫算他为义。
Only those who did not work, but they still gained this gift. This is what it means by being counted.
所以这就叫算。
And that is what it means to be counted.
而且保罗在这个罗马书第三也举大卫的例子，说大卫称那在行为之外蒙神算为义的人是有福的。
And here in Romans 4, Paul also gives the example of David that blessed are those whose lawless deeds are forgiven.
说得赦免其过，遮盖其罪的，主不算为有罪的，这人是有福的。
So blessed is the man against whom the Lord will not count his sin.
所以神算亚伯拉罕为义。
So God counts Abraham as righteous.
那这句话是在创世纪的十五章里面讲到的。
And this is spoken in Genesis 15.
在创世纪的十五章，我们知道神给亚伯拉罕的应许，神说就是说我要把这地赐给你的后裔。
And in Genesis 15, God promised Abraham that I will give this land to you and your descendants.
但亚伯拉罕没孩子啊。
But Abraham has no son.
亚伯拉罕就对神说：“主啊，难道你要赐给我在我家里那个大马士人的那个以利亚敬吗
？”And so Abraham asked, "Are you going to give all this inheritance to this manager in my household, Eliakim?"
因为我没有儿子。
Because I don't have any heirs.
但是神给他说：“我要是你的后裔。”神就带领他出去。神说：“你出来。”亚伯拉罕就出来。神说：“你看天上。”他看天上。神给他说：“天上的星星有多少，我就要让你的后裔就有多少。”
And God brought him out and asked him to look at the stars in the sky. And God told him, "How many stars you see? That's how many heirs you will have."
然后就是在这样的一个处境当中说这句话，说亚伯拉罕信神，信神向他所应许的，神就算他为义。
And under this situation, Abraham believed God, and it's written that it was counted to him as his righteousness.
所以亚伯拉罕算为义，不是因为他的行为，而是因为他相信神所说的话。
And so Abraham was counted as righteous not because of his works, but because he believed in God.
我们在后来在保罗在罗马书的第四章就看到保罗在这里说亚伯拉罕神算他为义之后，神才赐下这个割礼做记号的。
And so here Paul in Romans 4 says after God has counted him as righteousness, then he's given the sign of circumcision.
所以是先有割礼还是先有那个算他为义
？Is it first counted or is it first circumcised？
所以神先算亚伯拉罕为义，然后再赐下割礼作为这个义的这个记号。
God first counts him as righteous and then give the sign of circumcision as a promise.
所以我们保罗在那阿哥就是说，我们是先有这个，先被称义。然后才有这样的一个行为。
And so Paul is arguing that we are first counted as righteous before we even have anything of work.
先被称义，然后才有义的行为出来。
And first we are counted as righteous, then we have righteous works springing from our life. 就在创世纪十五章的时候，神算为亚伯拉罕为义，然后在创世纪的二十二章的时候，亚伯拉罕才会献以撒。And it's only in Genesis 15 when God counts him as righteous that in Genesis 22 that he sacrifices his son.
以撒是亚伯拉罕所应许的，是神对亚伯拉罕所应许的后裔，对不对
？Isaac, isn't he the promised heir to Abraham?
但神对亚伯拉罕说：“你带着以撒，你要把他献祭给我。”
But God told Abraham, "You're to bring Isaac, and you're to offer a sacrifice of him to me."
亚伯拉罕没有说一句话。
Abraham didn't say anything.
没有争辩。
He didn't argue.
所以他带着以撒带到摩利亚山上，把柴堆都摆好，然后把以撒放在上面。
He brought Isaac to Mount Moriah. He arranged the woods and he placed Isaac on top and is about to kill him.
So, 当时有天使来阻止他。
And at that point, angels came and prevented him from doing so.
So, 我们在二十二章的时候看到亚伯拉罕信心的这个行为。
You see in Genesis 22 the actions stemming from his faith.
So, 我们在这里是看到先有信心呢，还是先有行为
？So here, do we have works first or is it faith first?
在十五章，因为亚伯拉罕信神，神算他为义，然后到二十二章才有他献以撒的行为出来。
In 15, he was counted already as righteousness because of his belief, and in 22, his actions was manifested.
但是另一个方面，神也要通过他这样的行为来测试他这个信心是真的还是假的。
But from another perspective, we see that God used his action to test to see if his faith is genuine or not.
所以这就是雅各书里面所说的，你的信心是真的吗？So,
that's what Book of James say. If your faith is true, it will produce actions.
所以我们在这里看到，就是说是先有信心，后有这样的行为。
And here we see it's faith first, and then works follow later.
然后在罗马书的四章，然后保罗在这里也是这样 argue。他说亚伯拉罕被称义的时候，在他受割礼之前。所以所有的外邦人，因着这个缘故，所有的外邦人，他就成为未受割礼之人的父。
And so Paul continues argues in Romans 4 that Abraham was counted as righteous before he was circumcised. So all the Gentiles who are uncircumcised calls him as the father of faith too.
所以所有未受割礼的人，亚伯拉罕就成为他的父，因为他被称义是在他受割礼之前。
So those who are uncircumcised, the Gentiles, they count Abraham as their father of faith because he was counted before he was circumcised.
但是保罗在那里继续说，因为他受了割礼，所以他又成为受割礼之人的父。
And Paul there continued to say, but because he was circumcised, he also became the father of those who are circumcised.
所以最后保罗的总结就是说，无论受割礼的还是未受割礼的，亚伯拉罕都是他们的父。
So Paul's conclusion is that whether or not you're circumcised, Abraham is your father of faith.
所以那个关键是什么？
So what's the key here?
关键是那个信。
The key is the faith.
由亚伯拉罕信神，神就算他为义。
Because Abraham believed God and it was counted to him as righteousness.
所以在这里第九节，加拉太书的第九节，他说：“可见那以信为本的人和有信心的亚伯拉罕一同得福。”
So in verse 9, that's why Paul writes that so then those who are of faith are blessed along with Abraham, the man of faith.
亚伯拉罕成为一切信心之人的父。
Abraham became the father of faith for all who have faith.
而且第八节保罗在这里说，就是说就早已传福音给亚伯拉罕说万国都必因你得福。
In verse 8, already the scripture foreseeing that the Gentiles will be blessed by Abraham.
我们在下面会讲这句话是什么意思。
And we'll continue to explain what this means.
然后紧接着十节到十二节保罗就在这里讲，你靠反过来讲，你靠行律法你是没有办法称义的。
Now in verse 10, Paul reverses the argument and say, well, if you go by the works, you will never be justified.
为什么？因为保罗在这里跟阿哥在第十节的保罗在这里说，因为凡不常照律法书上所诫一切事情去行的，就是被咒诅的。
Because Paul then here says, "Cursed be everyone who does not abide by all things written of the book of the law and do them."
所以这句话是什么意思
？What does this mean?
这句话的意思就是说，律法书上的所有的规条，如果有一条你没有遵守，你就是应当被咒诅的。
What does this means that all the book of the law, if you cannot keep one of them, you will be cursed.
你不要说我遵守了99%的律法。
You don't say I've kept 99% of the law.
所以神就应该算我为义。
So God should count me as righteous.
抱歉。
I'm sorry.
不是这样。
It doesn't work this way.
你如果有一条没有遵守，有半条没有遵守，那么你就是应当被咒诅。
If you didn't keep one or even half the law, you will be cursed.
所以保罗在十一节就总结说，没有一个人能够靠行律法在神面前称义。
So in verse 11, he says that no one is justified before God by the law.
所以我们在这有看到罗马书上有类似的东西，对不对？
And you will see,
保罗在这里说，所以我们称义是在律法之外称义。
And you see similar things in Romans that we are justified apart from the law.
所以在这里，保罗告诉我们说，没有行律法，没有办法来让我们称义。
Here Paul is saying that by working the law, we'll never be justified.
所以只有在福音里面，只有在基督里面，我们才能够被称义。
It is only in Christ, in Jesus, that we will be justified.
所以因信称义，这个信心的对象是什么？
So what is justification by faith? What's the object?
信心的对象是耶稣基督。
The object of our faith is Jesus Christ.
所以在创世纪里面，神对我们刚才看到的经文说，万国要因你的后裔得福，要因你得福。
So we see just now that in you shall all the nations be blessed.
然后在创世纪22章，其实就讲到万国要因你的后裔，因你得福什么意思？是因为要因你的后裔而得福。
In Genesis 22, you see that the nations will be blessed because of your heir.
然后在加拉太书紧接着在3章16节讲到什么？
And in 3:16 of Galatians, what do you see?
这个后裔是谁？
Who is this offspring?
所以这个后裔不是一个复数，是一个单数，是那个后裔，那个后裔是耶稣基督。
This offspring is not plural but singular to that offspring, and that offspring is Jesus Christ.
所以万国要因亚伯拉罕来得福，原来是在讲万国要因耶稣基督而得福。
And all nations will be blessed through Abraham actually means that all nations will be blessed through his offspring, Jesus Christ.
所以无论你是犹太人还是外邦人，都要因耶稣基督而得福。
So whether you're a Jew or a Gentile, you will be blessed through Jesus Christ.
都要因着对耶稣基督的信。
And you are to be blessed through faith in Jesus Christ.
So, 基督为什么呢？
Why Jesus?
因为基，所以保罗在这十三节讲到，基督既为我们的缘故受了咒诅。
And in verse 13, Paul says that Christ is becoming has be cursed for us.
就赎出我们脱离律法的咒诅。
Has redeemed us from the curse of the law.
基督为我们的缘故受了咒诅，什么意思？
Christ has been cursed on our behalf. What does it mean?
保罗在这里说，凡挂在木头上都是被咒诅的。我们知道，基督是挂在木头上的，是挂在十字架上的，是被咒诅的。
And here he says, "Cursed is everyone who is hanged on a tree." We know that the tree refers to the cross.
我们今天称耶稣基督为主。
And now we call Jesus our Lord.
我们今天来敬拜耶稣基督。
And today we're here to worship him.
但你有没有想到，耶稣基督是被咒诅的
？Have you thought that Jesus Christ is cursed for us?
有没有想过这个事？
Have you thought of this?
凡挂在木头上是被咒诅的，这是出自于《生命记》。
And cursed is everyone who's hanging on a tree. This is from Deuteronomy.
生命记的21章23节。
In Deuteronomy 21:32.
生命记的21章23节的上下文再来讲，就是说，人如果有顽梗悖逆的儿子，如果他悖逆不听话的话，他是要被治死的。
And so,
用石头打死。
In Deuteronomy 21, it's talking about if you have a rebellious son who refuses to obey his parents, he is to be stoned.
所以就是在这样的上下文当中，那上下文是在讲，就是那犯了必死的罪，要被处死的罪。
And under this context of capital punishment in Deuteronomy,
在这样的上下文当中，在讲到就是说，挂在木头上的是被咒诅的。
And under this context, we see that here it is written that cursed is everyone who is hung on a tree.
基督犯了什么必死的罪？
What sin has Christ committed? What sin does he commit deserving capital punishment?
要让他被咒诅。
That he is to be cursed.
在希伯来书里面告诉我们，他与我们一样，只是没有罪。
And in Hebrew it tells us that he is the same like us without sin.
基督没有罪，为什么要被咒诅？
If Christ is without sin, why is he cursed?
让我们很多人都知道答案，说你在这里为什么？未来未去为什么？
And many of us know the answer. We keep asking why.
这个答案不是很清楚吗？对吧？
It's not very clear, isn't it?
是的，基督是为我们被钉在十字架上。
And the answer is because Christ died for us on the cross.
基督是为我们的罪被钉在十字架上。
And Christ is nailed to the cross on our behalf.
所以基督为我们成了被咒诅的。
And because of us, on behalf of us, that Christ has been cursed.
其实是我们犯了那个必死的罪。
We are the one who have committed the sin deserving death.
是我们要被挂在木头上，成为那个被咒诅的。
We are supposed to be hung on the cross and cursed.
所以基督为我们受了咒诅。
And so Christ has been cursed on our behalf.
所以我们在整本圣经上，我们都看到基督这个赎罪的，在整本圣经上都讲到这样的预言。
The whole Bible talks about this prophecy of his atoning death.
我们在创世纪的创世纪亚当夏娃犯罪之后，我们看到有一个动物被杀了，对不对
？And in Genesis, we see after Adam and Eve sin, an animal was slaughtered.
我们在那个创世纪二十二章，我们看到当他们献祭的时候，当亚伯拉罕献以撒的时候，那最后没有献以撒，然后就是在说了一句话，在耶和华的山上必有预备。
And in Genesis 22, when Isaac was not sacrificed, there is a phrase that says the Lord will provide.
所以就有一个羊羔在那里被预备。
So there is a ram that was provided for the sacrifice.
那我们在新约圣经的时候，我们看到基督是神的羔羊。
And in the New Testament, we see that Christ is the Lamb of God.
所以基督为我们被钉在十字架上。
And Christ has died for us on the cross.
所以这就是，所以在十字节说，这便叫亚伯拉罕的福。因着耶稣基督可以临到外邦人。
That's why in verse 14 it says, so that in Christ Jesus, the blessing of Abraham might come to the Gentiles.
亚伯拉罕的福是什么？
What is the blessing of Abraham?
神算他为义。
God has counted him as righteous.
因为他信神，所以神算他为义。
Because he believed God, God has counted him as righteous.
神称他为义。
So God declares him as righteous.
便叫这样的福分。因着耶稣基督可以临到所有的外邦人
，so that this blessing in Christ Jesus might come to the Gentiles。
就这样的福分不仅是临到外邦人，而且临到所有相信耶稣基督的犹太人。
And not just to the Gentiles, but to all the Jews who believed in Christ Jesus.
因为亚伯拉罕是信心之父，他既是未受割礼之人的父，也是受割礼之人的父。
Because Abraham is the father of faith, he's the father of all who are circumcised and uncircumcised.
所以我们就因着相信，我们就。就领受了应许当中的圣灵。
And through faith, we receive the promised blessing of the Spirit.
所以保罗在这里讲的就是我们信主，所以我们能够得救，我们被称义，我们领受圣灵是因为什么呢？
And Paul here is saying, why is it that we are saved, that we receive the blessing and receive the Spirit?
是因为我们行律法了吗？是因为我们的好行为吗？是因为我们受割礼吗？
Is it because we have been circumcised, or is it because we have adhered to the works of the law?
保罗在这里说。
Paul says no.
保罗是在这里说，是因为耶稣基督为我们被咒诅。
Paul here says that it's because Christ has been cursed.
而我们借着这样的信心，我们就被连与耶稣基督，在耶稣基督里面，我们领受这样的福分。
And through this faith, we are united to Christ, so that we receive the blessings of Christ.
在耶稣基督里面，我们被称义，我们领受那个圣灵。
And in Christ we are justified to receive the Spirit.
所以这样才会有前面圣灵的重生、圣灵的感动、圣灵的引领。
And that's why you have the regeneration, the leading, and the guiding of the Spirit at the beginning.
才会有在圣灵当中所结出的那个果子，生命的改变和在逼迫、在患难当中的那种就是为义受逼迫这样的一种喜乐。
And you only then will you have the joy that when you have when you are persecuted for the sake of righteousness.
和为义受逼迫这样的坚韧。
And this perseverance that you have when you are being persecuted.
所有的这一切是因为我们因信耶稣基督。
All this because we believe in Christ.
所以你们得救，你们相信，是因为你们行律法，还是因为你们的信福音吗？
So you are saved. Is it because you do your works of the law, or is it because you have believed the gospel?
So Paul 在这里讲得很清楚。
Paul is very clear here.
那么我们在思想最后一个问题就是说，那这段经文这样的一个信心对我们今天讲了什么？
And so the last question I want to ponder is, what does this scripture then tells us today in our lives?
首先我是，我们那边有一句土话，我不知道大家在别的地方有没有，叫赶着不走，放了直跑。
So I have a saying in our hometown, which could you explain? I don't know how to translate that.
It means we someone push behind you and you will not move.But if no one pushes you, and you will move fastly, something like that.
Okay. So if someone pushes you, you will not move. But if no one pushes you, you will move voluntarily.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good. 所以就是赶着不走，放了直跑。我不知道大家那边有没有这样的方言，有没有这样的言语。所以。当我们讲到这个时候，我就很多时候在做父母的都有这样的经历，对不对？然后我们这个teenager的这些孩子的话，你就会有，你如果有teenager的孩子，你就会有这样的经历。
And as parents of teenager, you might have this kind of experience, actually.
那我们在这里不是说 teenager 怎么样，而是说 teenager 为什么他们在这个阶段以为他们发现了自己的 identity。
Now teenager at this stage when they realize their own identity, they realize something。
所以他们开始有自己的自己的身份的一个定位，有自己的一个意识，有自己的一个意志。
They have their own identity and they have their own decisions to make. They want to make their own decisions.
所以在这时候做父母的，我们就要比较聪明，然后你就要怎么样能够去尊重他。
And as parents, we have to be wise in order to honor and respect them.
然后怎么样用恩典来帮助他，而不是用律法来赶着他走。
And by grace, you are to motivate him or her, not through law.
所以这是对我们今天做父母的，所以有那个 teenager 的父母的话，我们要在这当中要有一点的这个反思。
And these are something that we ought to ponder if you have teenage children in your household.
那同样在夫妻关系当中也是这样。
Similarly in marital relationships.
所以当你老是想去 fix 对方的时候，你会发现你最终会很失望。
If you try all your ability to want to fix the other party, you will find that you'll be disappointed.
但当你如果以恩典去对待对方，你以爱去尊重对方，然后用爱来驱动的时候，你会发现不一样。
If you treat each other with grace, with honor and love, you find that it's different.
所以这个就是福音的道理。
This is the principle of the gospel.
那福音的道理是以爱驱动，以恩典去驱动的。
And the principle of gospel starts with the idea of grace and love.
而不是以律法去驱动的。
It's not through the law.
所以我们只知道在福音当中是因为耶稣基督先为我们而死。
And in the,
然后我们的生命才会被这样的恩典所激励所感动才会改变。
And in the gospel, because Christ first died for us, that's why we are inspired and motivated by this love.
那同样在教会里面的侍奉的时候，我们弟兄姐妹也是应该有这样的一个反思。
And similarly, for those of us who are serving in the church, we ought to have the same reflection.
我盼望我们在教会里面侍奉，我们是以福音为驱动的，是以爱为驱动的。
And I hope that as we serve in church, it is out of love and out of the gospel.
不是被 push 的。
Not because you are pushed.
不是说我应该做什么，应该做那样，不这样做就怎么样。
Not because of your duty bound to do this or that, otherwise you have some consequences.
而是一种出于自愿，而是甘心的去服侍的。
But it is out of your willingness and voluntarily.
所以我们在教会的服侍当中，我们要培养一个以福音驱动的这样一个服侍的模式。
And so in the church, we ought to promote a kind of gospel-driven service.
而取代当初以律法驱动的那种服侍的模式。
And to replace the kind of works-driven service that we have.
所以以福音驱动的时候，就是那个生命自动流露出来的，从爱当中流露出来的，我愿意去服侍。
And when you are driven by the gospel, it's a life that is flowing out of love that you are voluntarily willing to serve.
用在福音驱动的服侍方式是我在服侍神，我不是来跟随人的。
Because in a gospel-driven service, you know that you are serving God and not men.
所以很多的时候，在教会当中的时候，我们每个弟兄姐妹服侍的时候要小心，我不是看人，我不是看他的关，看与牧师的关系我来服侍的。
And many times when we are serving in the church, we have to be careful that we are serving not because of certain relationships or relationship with the pastor.
我觉得你的牧师不错，给我很投缘，所以我来教会里面服侍来帮你忙。
I think that I'm really good with the pastor, so I come here to help you.
那我来讲义气，来帮你忙。
Oh, I'm here because I'm on the brotherly, you know, spirit, and I want to help.
但其实不是不应该这样，而是说我们在因为我要服侍神，所以我在这个教会当中服侍。
But this should not be the case because our service should be driven by the love of God.
所以在这里有一点，就是说，当我们出信的弟兄姐妹，有信主在两年之的弟兄姐妹，我们让他参与服侍的时候要非常的小心。
And so this is why those new believers who have just come to Christ, we have to be very careful when we ask them to join in service.
为什么？因为福音驱动的服侍方式。模式呢背后是那个生命
，because the gospel-driven service behind it is their lives.
是在那个以为有这样的生命，然后对神的爱，所以我去服侍。
And because you have this life and that you love God, that's why you serve.
初信主的弟兄姐妹很火热，很火热，愿意去传福音，这个是非常好。但是他那个生命没有到那个程度。
It's very good for new believers to go and preach the gospel, but the life has not reached a certain maturity.
所以我们很多时候我们很容易看到他很火热，马上就是让他去服侍，但是我们。在的过程当中，我们会发现这些马上服侍的人，他们 就很容易，他们很容易会 bore out.
And so in new believers, maybe we see that they're very fervent, we want them to serve, but they're easily burned out.
为什么？因为他们心里面没有那个，那个生命没到那个地步。
Because in their life they have not reached the maturity yet.
所以我们盼望我们教会里面服事的时候 ，involve 那个在两年之内信主的弟兄姐妹的时候要特别的小心。如果你真的要 involve 他，你要对他有很好的跟进和牧养。
And if you want to involve a person who is a new believer, you have to really follow up on them.
所以这是以福音驱动的服事，以爱驱动的服事，而不是在律法当中的服事。
And this is the service that's motivated by love and the gospel.
好，我们总结我们今天所讲的。我们今天在这里看到保罗在这里讲到，是我们是因着信心，我们还是因着行为。
Now, if we conclude, Paul asks, is it by faith or is it by works that we're justified?
我们是得救是因着福音，还是说是出于律法？
Are we saved because of the gospel or is it because of the law?
那我们在这里也看到今天在就是说今天基督徒的一个动力基督徒的生活服事的一个动力是什么是律法呢还是说这个福音
And we also ask, what is the motivation for the Christian life? Is it the law or is it the gospel?
可律法驱动和福音驱动有什么不一样
What's the difference between being motivated by the law and being motivated by the gospel?
所以我盼我们的每一个弟兄姐妹我们都去反思我们在我们的生活还有我们在教会里面的服事，我们与弟兄姐妹间的关系，我们是在福音驱动呢，还是在律法驱动
？And we have to ask ourselves and to reflect whether our service is driven by the gospel or is it by the law.
与律法驱动，你会给人的感觉就是这个人很律法。
Now, if you are driven by the law, you give the impression that this person is very law-ish.
然后别人都很害怕你。
And many are very scared of you.
但以福音驱动的话，你会让人的感觉是这个人非常的 gracious。
And if you are driven by the gospel, you give the impression that you are very gracious.
他对别人非常的 gracious.
He's very gracious to others.
能够包容别人的错误。
And he can acknowledge the mistakes of others.
然后别人也愿意与你在一起。
And others are willing to be with you.
所以我们盼望我们能够进一步的反思，然后让那个福音。在我们心中，让神的爱在我们心中成为那个动力。
And I hope that we can continue to reflect, and that may the love of God be the motivation in our hearts.
特别我们在我们的孩子的牧养上面，在孩子的教养上面，我们在夫妻关系的当中，也是能够变成以福音为驱动，
and especially,
以恩典为驱动。
Especially in a relationship in the family, within the couple or with the children, that it may be driven by the gospel.
愿神祝福你。
May the Lord bless us.
天父，亲爱的主，我们感谢赞美你。
O Lord, Heavenly Father, we give thanks and praise to you.
主啊，你是万王之王，你是万主之主。
O Lord, you are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords.
主啊，你将你的话语赐给我们。
And Lord, you have given us your word.
你的话语比金金更加的羡慕。
And your word is more precious than rare gold.
比蜜甘甜。
It's sweeter than honey.
主啊，你的话语让我们得以自由。
And Lord, your word gives us freedom.
让我们在福音里面得以自由，让我们在福音里面我们可以喜乐的，然后出于爱的去服事。
So that in the gospel we can serve motivated by love.
你在福音里面释放我们。
And you have released us in the gospel.
主啊，我们感谢赞美你。
And O Lord, we give thanks and praise to you.
主啊，愿一切的荣耀颂赞归于你。听我们这样的祷告，奉靠主耶稣基督的圣名。
And O Lord, may praise and glory be to you. And hear our prayer. Pray this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.